Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. Today I'll show you how to set up actionable notifications on Home Assistant. I understand this topic has been covered already by my fellow YouTubers, but most of those tutorials are using native Home Assistant automations. I'll be doing the same but using Node-RED. I love the way Node-RED displays the whole flow on one screen where I can see all the steps in real time. It's just the personal preference, so I prefer Node-RED for native Home Assistant automation. If you haven't installed Node-RED on your Home Assistant, I have created a step-by-step tutorial on this. I'll leave the link to that video down in the description below. Alright, about the notifications, we all know what mobile notifications are. We have seen them popping on our phones from different apps. So today we are going to create few notifications in Home Assistant which will show up on your phone through Home Assistant application. Alright, before we start, I would assume you have already registered your phone on your Home Assistant installation through native Home Assistant app. If you want to receive the notifications when you are away and not connected to your home Wi-Fi, you must have enabled remote access as well to your Home Assistant. I have created a video on how to enable remote access to your Home Assistant using Cloudflare Tunnel. You should be seeing the link to that video on top right corner of this video right now. I'll leave the link in description below as well, just in case if you want to watch that video later. I'll be using my production Home Assistant installation for this tutorial, since I want to show you some real use cases and not just random examples about how notification works in Home Assistant. So to start, let's create a simple notification which will just provide us some info and there will be no action required against it. For the first example, I'll use the ring door motion sensor as the trigger to send a notification on my phone. Drag the state change node on the flow and give it a name. Since this is a binary sensor, so I'll just simply select Boolean. Click Done. Now drag a call service node. Give it a name and under the domain you need to select Notify. And under service, we can either select Notify again if I want to send the notification to all the devices which are added here, or if I just want to send a notification to an individual device, then I can simply select that device. If you're not seeing your device in the list, make sure you have downloaded and installed Home Assistant app in the device and registered it by logging into it. Now we need to configure the data field, which is the actual notification text that will be displayed on the phone. Click on drop down arrow and select JSON, then click on three dots at the other end of the text field and click on visual editor. Here we have to add a couple of items which are required for the notification. Now click on the drop down menu and then click add an item and name it title. You can type the title whatever you want to see in the phone. Then add another item and name it message. Type whatever message you like to see on the mobile device. Wire the state change node from true connection terminal to call service node and then deploy the flow. Now let's try it by triggering the binary sensor through the developer tools and setting the state of the binary sensor to on. As soon as we set the state of binary sensors to on, we should see a simple notification on our device. There you go. So that's a very simple notification just to pass any information on the device. Let's go one step further and see if we can pass additional data with the text information within the notification. So in our first example, we just triggered a notification when motion is detected on the front door ring. Let's add a live camera feed to the notification. Edit the call service node we created earlier, select JSON on the data field and open the visual editor. click on the drop-down menu next to the object on line 1 and click on Add Item. Name it Data and select the type as Object. Click on the drop-down menu button again and add an item. Name it Entity ID. Since this will be a string type item, so leave the type as string and enter the camera entity which you want to show live feed for. Save the call service node and deploy the flow. Let's test the notification again by setting the state of binary sensor to on from the developer tool. Once the motion is detected and you have received the notification, note the camera feed preview is part of the notification. Now, if you tap and hold or long press on the notification, you should be able to see the live feed of the camera. So in this example, we just added additional information to our notification. Alright, so far we have set up notifications which did not require any input back from the user to Home Assistant. Let's add an automation where we can respond to the notification we are receiving. So I'll be adding an automation which will notify me if my garage door is left open for more than a set time. Then we'll add a close command within the notification if garage door is still not closed within the set time. This will initiate reminders until the garage door is closed. For me, this notification is very critical. I have set up my network cabinet in the garage, which houses my NAS, my NVR, my UDM Pro, my switches, and all other networking equipment. So I can't afford to leave the garage door open for long, especially when no one is home. Alright, let's do it. Drag a new state change node. Give it a name. Select the entity. For this example, I'll set the time for 10 seconds so that we don't have to wait longer for the notification to show up. So this will basically wait for 10 seconds after the garage door is open before sending out a notification. Drag a new call service node. Give it a name. Domain will be notify. Select the device you want to send the notification on. To set the data as we did before, select JSON and go to Visual Editor. Create an item and call it title and enter the title. Then create another item, call it message and enter the message you want to see. Now wire the state change node from true connection terminal to call service node and deploy the flow. Now let's quickly test it by setting the state from the developer tool. Once we set the state of garage door to open, it will wait for 10 seconds before sending out the notification. Alright, we got the notification, so we can move to next step. Now let's add the actions into the data field, which will allow us to respond to this notification. So under the call service node, add an item and call it data. Select the type as object. Then add another item under the data and call it actions. Select the type as array. Click the drop-down menu next to the actions and add a new item. Since we are sitting in an array, the system will automatically set it as 0, means that the first item or action in the array called actions. Select the type as object. And now click on the drop-down menu next to object 0 and then add an item. Call it action. Enter the action which will be close it now. You can type in whatever you want, but Just make sure it's all in caps. Go back on the drop-down menu next to Object 0 again and add another item. Call it title and enter the title. Save the node and then deploy the flow. Go to developer's tool and set the state of garage door to open again to trigger the notification. Now, when you get the notification and tap and hold on it, you should be able to see a new option popping up to close the glass door. If we tap on it, it won't do anything as we haven't set it up yet. Before we fire action to close the garage, let's understand how it all works. In Home Assistant, there are different types of event which have their own services to listen or fire. Go to developer tools and then in the events, here you can see different types of event which can be fired on the event bus or can be listened to. For this video, we are interested in listening the event type, mobile app notification actions. Copy this from the right side list and then paste it under the listen to event. And then click on the start listening. Go back to Node and in Airflow, drag a new node event all. Give it a name and paste mobile app notification action under event type. Then search for a debug node. Drag it into the flow and change its output type to complete message output. Wire the event all node with a debug node and deploy the flow. Trigger the notification again by setting the state from developer's tool. Once the notification is received, tap and hold and then tap on close garage door. Now go back to developer's tool and under events, you should see a new event fired with all this information. All we need to do here is just grab the info we require to complete the action basically. Similarly, on the Node-RED, debug node has pulled in the required info, which we can use to send a command to garage door, which will complete the action. On the right side of the Node-RED, under the debug tab, you should see the output of debug node. Here we are looking for the object called action and then close underscore it underscore now, as we configured it under the call service node previously. Click on the first icon to copy the path. We'll use this in a new node called switch. Search for a switch node and drag it onto the flow. Under the property, paste the path you just copied from the debug information. Next, for the comparison, leave the double equal on and go back to debug info for the same object again, and this time copy the value using the middle icon and paste it in the switch node. The switch node will basically check what event was fired and the action required against it. Finally, add another call service node which will be a command to close the garage. Give it a name, domain will be cover, and service will be close underscore cover. And under the entity, select the garage door. Wire all three nodes and deploy the flow. Again, trigger the notification using developer tools. Once you get the notification, tap and hold on it and then tap on close the garage option. This should initiate a close command for garage. You can verify this from the Node-RED flow as well. So this is your first simple actionable notification. You can enhance this automation by adding more action and reminders. Before wrapping this video, I'll quickly go through an example below to show you how you can add more actions and reminder, for example. I have added a trigger node which will keep triggering the notification every 5 minutes until the garage door is not closed. Under the call service node, I have added two more actions, remind later or ignore. Remind later will allow reminders to go through. Ignore will disable all the reminders altogether. I'm checking those actions using this switch node as we have used it previously. Now switch node has two outputs. One is to close the garage and the other one is to stop the reminder. If close the garage option is selected, the close garage will simply send a command to garage using a call service node as checked previously. If ignore is selected, ignore command will stop all the reminders which my trigger node is sending. To reset the trigger, I have used change node and set it to send a reset message to trigger node which will stop sending the reminders. The icons I have set in the call service node for notifications are SF symbols for Apple devices. These are different to home assistant material design icons. I'll leave the link down in the description below for SF symbols. Alright, this is it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.